the birthplace of a gentleman not too many people heard of, Elvis Presley. But to be with thousands of incredible patriots who put their faith in God, family, and country. Four days from now, this state will head to the polls and vote to continue our extraordinary progress with your next governor, Republican Tate Reeves. Under Republican leadership, jobs are booming, confidence is soaring, wages are rising, crime is falling, and our nation is stronger than ever before. We are now an economic powerhouse. We've never been in a position like it. We've rebuilt our military, and we have financial strength. And by the way, for those of you with a thing called 401ks, the stock market hit today another all-time historic high. Has reached the lowest rate ever recorded. Ever recorded. That's not bad when you're on the debate stage. And you say we have the best economy we've ever had, we have the best military we've ever had, the best unemployment and employment numbers we've ever had. So the best president we've ever had.
Against the righteous might of the United States.
military. And Mississippi loves our military, that I can tell you. Our military loves Mississippi. America is winning again, and America is all over the world respected again. It's about time. Creating jobs and killing terrorists, the Democrat Party has gone completely insane. The radical left is determined to transform America into a country you would not recognize. We are the ones standing in their way, and we will never get out of their way. It will be easy. Before we won the election, the far-left Democrats and the fake news media, right back there, look at all of them. It's too bad we get such good ratings, because if we didn't, they wouldn't be here. Look at how many. It's like the Academy Awards before it failed. And you know why it failed? Because they disrespected us. But the media and the Democrats have been engaged in a corrupt partnership trying to impose their will and to thwart American democracy by any means necessary. You see what's going on. First, they engineered the Russia hoax. That was a total hoax. The single greatest lies ever foistered upon the American people. Then the Mueller witch hunt, it never ended, with 18 angry Democrats and an unlimited budget. Let's go get him. That didn't work out too well, did it? That fizzled. A lot of bad people along the way. And now corrupt politicians, Nancy Pelosi, and the media are continuing with the deranged impeachment witch hunt. This is one I never thought I'd be involved in. The word impeachment, to me, it's a dirty word, not a good word. Totally phony deal. They know it. Everybody knows it. And that's why we've never had greater support than we have right now. It's this room, all you have to do is go outside. You'll see a lot more people trying to get out. So if anybody wants to give up your seat, please just walk out, somebody. Anybody want to leave? Because there really is, there's no place better to have a rally, to have a good time, and to also, at the same time, be very serious than at a Trump rally, especially on Friday night. We could have done this one on Monday night. He said, let's do Friday, right? Friday's. Yesterday, the Democrats voted to potentially nullify the votes of 63 million Americans, disgracing themselves and bringing shame upon the House of Representatives. The election since the moment I won, but the people here that are highly sophisticated know long before I won. 19 minutes after I took the oath of office, the horrible newspaper, fake, Washington Post, declared the campaign to impeach President Trump has just begun. At least they gave us 19 minutes. Yesterday's vote by the radical Democrats is an attack on democracy itself. But I'll tell you, the Republicans are really strong. The strongest I've ever seen them. The most unified. The American people are fed up with Democrat lies, hoaxes, and extremism. Yeah. The Democrats' outrageous conduct has created an angry majority that will vote many do-nothing Democrats out of office in 2020. Make no mistake, they are coming after the Republican Party and me because I'm fighting for you. They don't like it. This is different. They've never had anything like this. Well, they've never had an election like 2016 either, have they? They've never quite figured it out. And they know they can't win. So let's try and impeach them. How about that crazy Representative Al Green, right? You know? I don't impeach him because we can't beat him. I don't think so, right? I don't think so. Al Green, he's another beauty. The Democrats, the media, and the deep state are desperate to stop us. And it's not me, it's us, it's all of us. It's 63 million, but it's much more than 63 million, much more. And right now, our numbers are higher than they've ever been before. So, stop us because they know we are here, and that's what we're doing, and that's what's taking up so much time. We're draining the swamp in Washington. Nothing terrifies Democrats more than the fact that all of their spying. They actually spied on my campaign, can you believe it? I mean, you know, they try and say, well, we were actually just checking things out. Oh, that's wonderful. The lying, the falsifying, over the past 3 years plus, before I ever even announced they were spying. I guess they knew we were going to win, right? But over that past more than 3 years is finally being exposed. And remember this, that truth is a force of nature. Desperate to conceal their misdeeds, the Democrats are now attacking us for calling out the grave corruption of the Bidens, just like they melted down when we pointed out crooked Hillary shocking and very many misdeeds. Emails disappeared, but she said they only had to do with her working out at her daughter's weight. But I know one thing. She's not an agent of Russia. No. And Jill Stein, she's a greenie. That's fine. We love the environment, everybody in this room. You know, right now we have the cleanest air and the cleanest water that we've ever had, and yet we're number one in the world in energy by far. I don't know, but I know she's not an agent of Russia. And when Hillary made those statements, two statements, both of them, they work for Russia, they're agents of Russia. I said, you know, when she made that statement about me 3 years ago, it took me 2 years to get out of that hoax statement. She made it about them, everybody laughed because of what we proved. But I'll tell you what, these are very bad people, these are very dishonest people, and the media is worse than all of them. Yeah. Think about the preposterous hoax the Democrats are now trying to peddle. I've just beaten, with no political, look, We didn't have too much political experience. I did a good job, built lots of buildings all over the place, had great success in show business, just did one show, it was called The Apprentice. I would appreciate that. 14 seasons, and when I left, Crazy Arnold took off. It didn't do too well. It was dead. It was dead from the first episode. I saw him, I said, oh, it's terrible. What have they done to this beautiful show? Arnold. But think of it, I've just beaten with no political experience. The Clinton dynasty, the Bush dynasty, the President Barack Hussein Obama dynasty. At defeating me than crooked Hillary Clinton did. He was all over the place. The only time I've actually seen him work hard when it came to trying to beat Trump. Remember he said, he will not be president. Well, that didn't work out so well. Could take us out a different way, very dishonestly, right? With the lying and the spying and the leaking. And we are kicking their ass. In the delusional Democrat fantasy, I'm now supposed to be afraid of someone called 1% Joe. I used to call him 1% because he could never get 1% in the primaries. Then he got brought out by Obama out of the trash heap. Became vice president. But we've now named him Very Slow Sleepy Joe. He's gotten slower and slower. I'm afraid if he gets a nomination, he'll be so slow. We'll have the lowest rated debates in history. As opposed to the highest rated debates in history against Crooked Hillary. In fact, I don't even think that Sleepy Joe will get it, but many people are running. So, you know, it's so early. I don't want to talk about their campaign. Oh, did you hear? Beto, did you hear? Beto. Oh, that poor bastard. Look. He's pathetic. Remember the arms that flail. Remember that, you know? He ran against Ted Cruz. Ted Cruz won. He spent almost $100 million. And Ted Cruz and I helped Ted, and we campaigned together, and it was good. But I used to watch him. Then when he came onto the really big stage, his crazy stage, I noticed he was flailing with the arms and he was standing on tables. He was standing on countertops. I said, does he ever like stand on the floor and speak? But he's waving his arms and going crazy. And I said, what the hell is he doing? What is he on? And you remember he made the statement that he was born for this. Anybody that says he was born for this, they're in trouble. You know, I used to have guys come into my office. Sir, I'm the greatest salesman. Nobody can sell. You know, the truth is, anybody that says they're a great salesman, usually they're not a very good salesman. It's true. It's those sneaky ones in the back that don't talk. That you don't know about. They're the ones. But Beto was nasty. And he said that he was born for it. Like he was. Twisted and corrupt world of Adam Schiff, after beating the entire political establishment, and that means Bush, and that means Clinton, and that means Obama, they had me supposedly saying to myself, well, let's see. I got a guy named Sleepy Joe Biden. How do I beat him? How do I beat him? How do I beat this guy? He's such a great Clinton. She was easy. Right? Obama was easy. The Bush dynasty was easy. But Sleepy Joe, I'm worried about, right? So then I said to myself, gee, I guess there's only one way. Let's call up Ukraine for help. These people are sick. These people are sick. Now, these dishonest people will take the last little sliver and the first little sliver, and they'll put it because they're so damn dishonest, and they'll just say, let's use Ukraine for help. That's what they're going to say. And they won't show the laughter, and they won't show the sarcasm, and they won't show the fun, because they're the most dishonorable people almost on earth. It's a disgrace. And here's the good news, the people get it. So they have a brand new president in Ukraine, good guy, by the way. And I call a brand new person, a man I have no idea who he is. And I'm on a phone, right? And I know many people are on the phone. Because when you call the leaders of country, many people listen. And I'm on the phone, and they want me to say to this brand new president who just got there, called to congratulate him, please, could you help me, please? I don't know who he is. I didn't know his name until I looked down the card, I said, and he's a nice guy. And hopefully he's going to root out corruption because Ukraine has tremendous corruption problems. And hopefully, and one of the reasons I held up money, very important, corruption. But the other reason, why is Germany and France and UK and all of these European nations that are right there, why aren't they doing things that they're supposed to do? Call, had this wonderful call, and the transcript proves it was, as I said, perfect. It was perfect. It wasn't like almost, but it was perfect. It was totally appropriate. I made it at the behest of people to say, could you call and say hello? Now, I'm an honest person anyway, but do you think when I'm making a call to a newly elected, some kind of a deal with all these people? And remember, the new president of Ukraine is speaking to the United States of America, the president. I guarantee he's got a lot of people listening to him. These people are sick. So, corrupt politician, shifty Adam Schiff, actually stood before Congress and stood before the American people and made up a conversation that he said I had with the Ukrainian president. And many people saw that, and it was a terrible, he said terrible things. The president of Ukraine said it was a very good conversation, there was no pressure. His foreign minister said the same thing, no pressure. They must think we're nuts, to be honest. It's all a phony deal, this whole impeachment scam, to try to undermine the 2020 election and to delegitimize one of the greatest elections, maybe the greatest. I mean, let's give George Washington credit, what everybody expected he was doing. That we've ever had. So my phone call, which was totally perfect and appropriate, and if you want to read the transcript, you see how perfect it was. But they don't quit. But what you should do is take a look at the behavior of Sleepy Joe. So I quote, I said, let me act like him. I got to speak really slow, though. I said, I'm not getting a billion. I looked at them and I said, I'm leaving in 6 hours. If the prosecutor isn't fired, you're not getting the money. Do you understand? You're not getting the money. Then he goes at the end, I didn't know he had this kind of energy. He goes, well, son of a bitch, he got fired. You know, in a certain way, I was impressed because I mean, I didn't think he had the energy, the brain power. It's turned out he doesn't. By the way, he's dropping like a rock. You know, when you're at 1%, there's always a reason. You should be there fairly soon. As you know, the Ukrainian prosecutor that Biden got fired after threatening to withhold, I think it was $1 million or something in aid, was the prosecutor investigating his son's company that was paying Hunter Biden. A guy just got thrown out of the Navy. He was paying him millions of dollars, even though working for an energy company, he had no experience with energy. He knew less about it than this young, how old are you? Six. This young, beautiful person. Six. And this young six-year-old is smarter, so I think I'd basically go with her. So, what is it all about? It's called a payoff. But you know what? The fake news, they apologize. I watched this horrible guy with his lousy ratings, Anderson Cooper. Well, the hatred. In between him and Fredo, you got Fredo. That's Cuomo. Fredo. I call him Fredo. Like from the movie. He never spoke to him. Unfortunately, the next day, you know, in the world of the internet, in the world of smart people, that's why, like, Beto wasn't smart. Couldn't handle it. I told my wife, I said, see, it's not so easy. I told our great first lady tonight, who people love. Like a dog. When he quit, I said, see, people think this is easy. This isn't easy. But, you know, it just worked out that way. But Biden said, I never met the people, never met the gentleman. Unfortunately. No, it stops. I tried not to do that because I see their light on. You know, when their light goes on, that means you're alive. No, that means you're alive. And every time, it's tough. Look, in all fairness, they're putting it on. It's a broadcast. Very few people are watching. Well, they might be watching us. I guess they do watch us. But here's the thing. And then you have the guy up there saying that they're fake, that they're no good, that they're liars and cheaters, that they're phonies. It's hard to be broadcasting that when you're talking about the network that has you on, right? So we understand. The light's off. And then, Anderson Cooper, what a beauty. He used to interview me. It was so nice. Prior to running for politics, he was so nice to me. It was like they were love fests. But I don't want anything to do with him. They were love fests. What a thought. No anymore. Somebody wants to call. And they came into my office, and then I got to get back to this guy. Where's Hunter? Where's Hunter? You know, we had a t-shirt made, where's Hunter? Where's Hunter? Poor Hunter. He then came out. He did the morning show. That was the last we've seen of Hunter. That was in the morning of his father's very bad debate. But it's where's Hunter? But so before I say the final thing, it's so, in my opinion, it's virtually corrupt. I've never seen it. You never have a good story. I mean, even with, when we got Al Baghdadi, the Washington Post had a story that he was like a great religious cleric. Where did that come from? The other thing, if Obama would have done it, because look, this guy built ISIS. The caliphate, it was the size physically of Ohio, the state of Ohio, the great state of Ohio. That's a big lot of land, 7 million people. And they were the ones, the orange jumpsuits. I called a lot of the parents after we did this, and I talked to them, and they were, how can you be happy? But they were so thrilled that we got this animal. They were so thrilled. But you know what? And you know what? We do it because it's right. That story was a massive story. That was the biggest, maybe the biggest, one of the biggest ever. Bigger than anything. That story disappeared so fast. God. And that's okay. Be about this. Conan, The dog got more publicity than me. And Conan's coming to the White House in a few weeks. But it is true. Did you ever see a story disappear so fast? I mean, here, if Obama had that story, that thing would be going on for another 7 months. They'd be talking about his bravery, oh, so bravery. But again, 142 judges he gave us, remember that. How can you be a great... You know, they always say, the most important thing a president can do is federal judges. We got two Supreme Courts. There are other places also, I understand. Folks, it's disgraceful that the press doesn't cover it for what it is. It's a payoff. It's a payoff. And how would you like to have Sleepy Joe, with the son getting all of this money from China, become president and take over the China deal? They are not liking me. They had the worst year that they've had in 57 years. Their supply chain is broken up like scrambled eggs. And they want to make a deal because those tariffs are giving us billions of dollars and billions now. Billions. So when I said to the farmers, we're going to send you $16 billion, and it's already been said that it's been split into $12 billion the year before. I mean, think of that, $28 billion. I said, compliments of China. And we had a lot left over. Not bad, right? Said that I said it. I said, oh, I'm going to sue him. They said, sir, I'm sorry, you can't. He's got total immunity because he made it in Congress. Can you believe this? But you know, here's the good news. At least we have a forum. We have a place we can talk so everyone knows what's going on. Bunch of phony people. But this is why we have to send a signal and why you have to make Tate Reeves your great new leader. Supports taxpayer funding for abortion providers. He supports illegal immigration on all benefits. And he opposed our travel ban, which is so important that we won in the United States Supreme Court to keep terrorists the hell out of our country. And Jim Hook went to the United Nations and opposed your right to self-defense.
Thank you, Mr. President. Is Donald J. Trump country. We gave you almost 60% of the vote in.
Second Amendment is under attack. Not with him. It's under attack. So we're also joined tonight fighting Luke's life. So another man who's a warrior, he's a friend of mine, whenever there's a...
Mississippi. Illegal borders for drug smugglers to come through them. We
fantastic woman. So also with us, two terrific friends of mine that like Roger and like Cindy Heitzman and like all of them. And Tate, he's going to be right there. He'll be right up there with us, all fighting together. Two incredible people, Trent, Kelly, Michael Guest. Incredible people. And your next Lieutenant Governor, Delbert Hoseman. Your next Attorney General, Lynn Fitch. Secretary of State, Michael Watson. The next State Treasurer, David McRae. It's impossible. Unemployment has reached the lowest rate in over 51 years. African American unemployment just dropped to the lowest rate ever recorded historically. Really unimportant to me. The African-American youth unemployment rate is the lowest ever recorded in the history of our country. We lifted 55,000 Mississippi residents out of poverty. 55,000. Are up 9%. After years of building up foreign nations, we are finally building up our nation. We are finally putting America first. Our policy of never-ending war, regime change and nation building is being replaced by the clear-eyed pursuit of American interests. It is the job of our military to protect our security, not to be the policemen of the world. Proving the wisdom of this approach, we recently secured a permanent ceasefire in northern Syria, without spilling one drop of American blood. Actually, I have to be honest, one soldier stepped on a nail. I said, don't tell the press that because they'll say, one soldier stepped on a nail. I said, how bad was it? It's okay. He said, don't mention it, please. They always like to mention exactly what happened. Take it a little bit low key. Step to the nail. Not a drop of blood. And we don't have to defend the borders between Turkey and Syria. They've been fighting for 1,000 years. Very adventures turn faraway nations into very, very dangerous war zones. Then they demanded that American citizens accept unlimited migration from those terror-afflicted nations and regions. I don't think so. I don't think so. We did not fight them over there only to invite them over here. To protect our communities, my administration restricted migration from terror money for everything, but when it came to the wall, not 10 cents. But we gave the military. The American people are not ever going to back down from perhaps the greatest victory in political history. And you know, today with the new stock market at an all-time high, it's, I will tell you something, If we didn't win this election, that stock market would be in one half. It was heading in the wrong direction. It was going. You have to give up. You're going to leave work maybe a little earlier, maybe get there a little late. Tell your boss I said it was okay. In Congress to create a fair, safe, sane, and lawful system of immigration. And you have great congressmen here, and I'll tell you, I want to appreciate it, fellas. Warriors. You're warriors. You are warriors. What was it? 196? 4-0 against, huh? That doesn't happen with Republicans. It doesn't happen. I always complain, I always say, the Democrats are lousy politicians. They have lousy policies, open borders, sanctuary cities. But they have one thing, they stick together. And they're vicious. The Republicans have great policy. In many ways, they're better politicians. But they're not as vicious. Thank you, darling. I appreciate it. They're not as vicious. But they have a tendency to split apart. The Democrats don't seem to have USA. We will achieve new breakthroughs in science and medicine, finding new cures for childhood cancer, and ending the AIDS epidemic in America. Can you believe that? Within 10 years, it will be over. When they told me that, I said, that's incredible. We're going to end the AIDS epidemic within 10 years. It's funded. Nobody would have thought we could do that, but we're doing it. We'll have it ended in America in 10 years. We'll never stop fighting for the sacred values that bind us together as one America. We support, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States. We stand with the incredible heroes of law enforcement. We believe in the dignity of work and the sanctity of life. We believe that faith and family, not government and bureaucracy, are the true American way. We believe that children should be taught to love our country, honor our history, and to always respect our great American flag. Motto, and we always will. You'll never see it disappear. In God we trust. We stand on the shoulders of American patriots who crossed the oceans, settled the continent, tamed the wilderness, dug out the Panama Canal, laid down the railroads, revolutionized industry, pioneered technology, won two world wars, defeated fascism and communism, and made America the single greatest nation in the history of the world, and today it's greater than ever before. Proud citizens like you help build this country, and together we are taking back our country. That's what we're doing. That's what happened in 2016. We are returning power to you, the American people. With your help, your devotion, and your drive, we are going to keep on working, we are going to keep on fighting, and we are going to keep on winning, winning, winning. You're winning. You had the best year you've ever had. You know, you have the best Mississippi, the best year you've ever had in the history of our country, Mississippi. And Mississippi, aren't you getting tired of winning? I guess so. So Phil doesn't come to me and say, sir, please, we're winning too much. The people of Mississippi can't take it anymore. I don't think you'll ever have to make that trip. I don't think he's ever going to have to, and I don't think Tate will ever have to make that trip. We are one movement, one people, one family, and one glorious nation under God. And ladies and gentlemen of Mississippi, the best is yet to come. Because together we will make America wealthy again. We will make America strong again. We will make America proud again. We will make America safe again. And we will make America